Welcome to Blueprints Unsealed, a series of reflections and thought depicting the life and times of society's most influential people, ideas, and culture. Nothing can move faster than the speed of light. At this rate, in less than 1 second, you will travel around the Earth 7.5 times, which is really not that fast. In fact, it takes light from the sun approximately 8 minutes to reach Earth. But if we wanted to send humans to the sun, using the fastest rockets, it would take almost half a year. Unfortunately, the further your journey into space, the time and distance exponentially increases. The vastness of the universe is simply put, unfathomable, and the time it would take to travel through our own galaxy would make it an impossible task. Therefore, when the government alludes to the idea that we are being visited and monitored by these strange objects that apparently defies our understanding of aerodynamics or physics, we are left with the impression that the government is completely clueless as to the origins of these specimens, which they call unidentified aerial phenomena, or UAPs for short. However, some evidence suggests that the government knows much more about these UAPs than they will have us to believe. It has been highly speculated for a long time that the number one source for conspiracies may have come from deep inside the chambers of government bureaucracies. Certain insiders may reveal information for various reasons. Some are whistleblowers interested in exposing corruption. Others may consist of disgruntled members that have nefarious intentions aimed at damaging the reputation of certain members of the government and its agencies. However, there are situations where their false rumors and misinformation is disseminated by the government institution under the guise of national security. When information is purposefully leaked by the government, the intent is much different than those of a whistleblower or a disgruntled current or ex-employee, whereas the intended audience for these two scenarios is aimed at the American people. However, when the leak comes from the government itself, the targeted audience is usually aimed at foreign government powers, a way to send a message, a posturing tactics used to confuse, cause fear, or discourage a particular behavior from a foreign opposition. During the Trump administration, he expressed his desire to have a military parade in celebration of Veterans Day. The purpose of a military parade is basically to showcase the might of a nation's defense. It is a practice that dates back centuries, where warriors would demonstrate how skilled they were in order to intimidate their adversaries or victims. In all fairness, the practice of parading the military is a common thing, and it's something that other nations do. Today, the tradition of a military parade is more ceremonial than anything. In fact, if a nation wants to showcase its abilities, is done by running military drills close to the subjects they wish to intimidate. However, for various reasons, many government officials did not support the idea of having a military parade. The main concerns were safety, cost, logistics, but perhaps most importantly, there were concerns involving the symbolic nature of what a military parade would indicate for a free nation. In the midst of planning for this parade, something interesting happened in South America. In 2018, during a military parade in Venezuela, there was an attempt to assassinate the president of that country. During his speech, according to the Venezuela's Minister of Communication, the attack consisted of several explosive drone-type devices that were detonated in the vicinity of the presidential stage and in other areas of the parade. Live video showed the chaos that ensued shortly after the explosions. Even the military got scared off as everybody ran into a frenzy. In hindsight, they probably had some regret hosting this event because the way the military ran off can be perceived as a lack of discipline or worse, the absence of proper leadership. However, some people may find that the timing of the attacks strangely coincides with President Trump's desire to have a military parade back in Washington, D.C. What I find strange is that none of the explosions caused fatalities, as if someone took special care not to harm anyone. but to send a message. Could this whole thing have possibly been a setup in efforts to deter Trump's military parade? Or do you think this was just one big coincidence? The U.S. government has a history of being less than forthcoming when it comes to their military operations or other covert agendas. Take Area 51, a secretive military operation base located in Nevada. Although the site was well known to the public since its inception, it was rumored to contain highly advanced technology that may have come from extraterrestrial origins. Even though the site was built in the late 1950s, the government did not formally acknowledge this existence until 2013, as a result of the Freedom of Information Act. But if we pay attention to the year that the site was constructed, it coincides with the Cold War era, a time when the U.S. and Russia were competing to develop weapons, planes, and space probes. During this time, the reporting of UFOs hit an all-time high. However, one can logically deduce that the mass reportings was caused by these newly developed and classified space vehicles that the government was secretly testing all over the country. In fact, there's a real possibility that the government is responsible for putting out there this idea of extraterrestrial activities, perhaps as a secret line of communications for those that are in the know. But before I get to this explanation, I think some background information is warranted. Many historians view the Cold War as a period of escalating tensions between the U.S. and the Soviet Union. However, this era was also shrouded in an environment where secrecy was the strategy employed by both sides. Where traditional wars are fought over land, the Cold War was fought for intelligence. Both sides were tasked with the objective of not only gathering intelligence, but decoding the messages, and then trying to decide if the information was legit or a trap. We know today that the KGB would transmit secret messages over live broadcasting stations. The radio was also a good way to get a pulse on public sentiment regarding various issues. Therefore, it is highly likely that the U.S. government purposely started this rumor of UFOs in order to confuse and distract the KGB agents listening in. And perhaps it was the U.S. government's way of showcasing their abilities to develop technology that seems extraterrestrial in nature. In the beginning of the video, I mentioned that the speed of light is the fastest thing there is, and nothing but pure energy can travel at that velocity. This concept has been theorized and proven right for over a century. More importantly, this discovery has led to the advancement of mankind in so many ways. Therefore, if we hold this theory as true, then it becomes impossible to explain how such an advanced form of intelligence would be able to travel to Earth from such a distant place. Although I do believe that life exists in the universe, I do question if those light forms is capable of traveling here and displaying all types of maneuvers that seem to defy our laws of physics. This idea seems, well, very trippy. However, the truth of the matter can get even stranger. It's time to think beyond the scope of the universe. If UAPs are appearing to defy the laws of physics, this may indicate that we are experiencing an illusion of sorts. Perhaps something similar to a hologram, because the laws of physics should apply to everything and every being that was created in the universe in the same manner. However, this can also be indicative of an interdimensional being, where the laws of physics may affect the UAP differently than how we interact with the world. And lastly, perhaps we may be dealing with future time travelers who are here to observe the past. This may explain why the UAPs appear to behave in such an odd manner. But of course, these are just my thoughts on the matter. In the end, can we really expect for the government to release information concerning ETs through this new disclosure bill that was recently passed? Besides, I thought this was the purpose of the Freedom of Information Act that passed a while ago. I think we all agree. that the answer is absolutely not. But fortunately for us, we do not need to rely on the government for answers. Besides, the most groundbreaking discoveries ever made typically did not generate from within the government itself. But to the contrary, discoveries and answers always comes from people who collaborated with like minds that also had a thirst for knowledge. Thanks for watching. Please consider supporting the channel by hitting the like button and subscribing.